honestly, not much has changed. The budgets get a little bigger, you know, the hair got a little curlier, but it's all still kind of tap dancing about garbage plates. Hi, I'm Tawny Newsome, and this is The First Time. The first time I bought an album with my own hard-earned allowance money. You know, you get tempted to lie and say like something cooler than what you actually bought. Oh, actually, I think it was En Vogue Funky Divas. If we're counting tapes, I think I bought it in a big warehouse store. I want to say it was like a Costco or something. And for whatever reason, they had tapes of En Vogue Funky Divas and then a giant stuffed panda. Those are my two purchases. I remember being like, I have $14 or whatever it is, and I want both of these things. And my mom was like, you got to choose. The first time I met Steve Carell, I don't have that shirt anymore because the pit stains were so egregious. He was delightful. It was my third audition, I think, for Space Force.
Greatness was never won without sacrifice.
Coming from Second City, there's a lot of like alumni and people that you run into, and you kind of have this like fraternity of like, hey, we all went through the same thing. But I'd never run into him or worked with him or met him or anything. So I didn't know I'd be lucky enough to get to work with him so much. But I would love to see that tape because I think that I must have looked insane. The first time I performed it, where people presumably had like paid something to come see it. Oof. Sorry to those people. I was in Rochester, New York, and I had been kind of last minute added to a cast for the Second City.
You know what's low fat as fuck? Plants, motherfuckers.
I remember I did like a tap number about their signature dish, which is called the garbage plate. So my introduction to comedy and finding my comedic voice was me literally tap dancing and singing the words garbage plate. I met Paul Simon. I was working at the Second City in Chicago, and we got word from our producers that he was coming to the show and he was bringing his son. And I like ran home. I had to grab Take Me to the Mardi Gras. Wait, no, what's the name of that album? Oh my God, my husband's gonna kill me. The one Still Crazy is on?
Still crazy after all these years.
Is it called Still Crazy? Ooh, I'm gonna get in trouble for this. But my husband was out of town. I knew he would like lose his mind at not getting to meet Paul Simon. So I ran home, grabbed that album and brought it back for him to sign. I think when we did meet him, he came backstage and stuff and played some like tunes with us. I think even he was like, when did you go get, like, do you travel around with one of my records on you? So I think he thought I just like kept that in my messenger bag. It was probably Nick of Time by Bonnie Raitt. I probably cried because my mom did. I feel like that's one of the songs that my mom cries at every time it comes on.
Those lines are pretty hard to take when
like so many of the things she's singing about, like a woman wanting a baby, like that's not my life. Like I don't share those same feelings, but it's still, it just tugs at me. I'm like, oh, yes, I get this. This is me. But I was also doing that at like age 12. We used to board our horse at this woman's house. And on the weekends, she would have this like little community event called team penning. Basically, it's you and a partner on horses. There's a corral full of cows with numbers glued on their back. And you got to get that cow into another smaller pen. And it kind of feels like, I don't know, just like a weekend sports game. So when other kids were going to like soccer, I was doing that. I remember I was hanging out with my high school friend, Michael, and he played the trumpet, something you don't sing along to, you know, I want to say it was a trumpet. And I had this melody in my head and it was just going to be like a dumb, like, you know, a comedic song. And I kept singing it and I kept going, oh, it goes like this. Da 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 da. And then he'd play it and I was like, that's not the right rhythm. And I kept doing it again. Da 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 da. And he just looked at me and he was like, this is the first song you've written and you're writing it in 6/8 like you're a fucking pirate. Like, what is this? I don't even remember what was on the screen. I remember it being in black and white. I remember a strange man talking right to the camera, which I hadn't seen much of before, except for on Sesame Street.
The Twilight Zone. The Twilight Zone. The Twilight Zone. The Twilight Zone.
And I was like, I don't know what this is, but I should not be here. It's too much. This is one of those things my parents probably sent me out of the room while they were watching, because I was an anxious kid and I think I would get too freaked out. The first time I recorded at Muscle Shoals, I believe it was November 12th of 2016. I think we all thought maybe the election was going to go a different way before we took a handful of weird black people and like a Welshman on this tour of the South through the middle of Alabama. But Muscle Shoals is an incredible enclave of hippies and weirdos and people who exist outside of politics while existing within it all at the same time. And it was such a beautiful place to be during such a weird time in this country. The first time I ever took a trip totally by myself, I went to Portugal. I had just finished doing a play at the Goodman Theater in Chicago, which was a big bucket list thing for a theater nerd like me. We would get these, you know, big audiences, and I just felt very like, I'm kind of done with a lot of people right now. I did a bunch of research about, like, you know, safe places, whatever, so that my dad wouldn't lose his mind. But the main goal of it was to do the Rota Vicentina, which is the coastal hike that goes down the western coast of Portugal. And it was perfect. And the best part about traveling by yourself is you do not have to do anything you do not want to do.